Welcome to Getting Started with Zotero. Zotero is an open source reference manager that you can use to create, store, and organize references. You can add in-text citations to your essays using Microsoft Word, for example, or Google Docs. And you can also create reference lists and bibliographies. In this video, we'll look at how to install Zotero, import a few references, and select the citation style for those references, using Harvard style as an example. We're then going to create in-text citations and finally a reference list. Before we begin, it's important to note that Zotero is a powerful tool that will help you research and write your academic assignments. However, it's important to check the accuracy and consistency of your citations and reference lists. You can do this by cross-checking your references with the examples given on the Cite Them Right platform, which you'll find in our A to Z of databases. There's help and support available. You can access our online Zotero guide on the library website. There are helpful forums available on the Zotero website, and you can always talk to us here in the library. Installing Zotero is fairly straightforward. All you have to do is go to zotero.org and click on Download. Select Download Zotero for Windows in this instance, and then you install the Zotero application. Once you're done, go back and install the Zotero connector, which will allow you to save references to Zotero from your web browser. There are also some plugins that you can consider. Just take a look at Browse Plugins. Once you've installed Zotero, you can launch the application from your Start menu. Just type in Zotero, click on Zotero app, and that will open the Zotero window. On the left-hand side, there's a folder structure. There's a central panel, which contains the content in your library. And on the right-hand side, you have the descriptive information of anything you save in there. Here, I've already created a folder that contains the information for a newspaper article I've saved. You can see the article's title, author, etc. are listed on the right-hand side. When you're starting your research for an assignment, first create a folder for that assignment in Zotero. To create a folder, click on the yellow folder icon, give the folder a name. For this example, we'll call it Test. At the moment, the folder is empty, so let's add a book title to it. For this example, we'll look up the book Doing Your Research Project by Bell on Library Search. Click into the record and go to the top of the page, where you'll see the Zotero connector you installed. Click on it and choose the Test folder, and then go back to your Zotero account. You can see that all the bibliographic information from the source has been saved into your Zotero account. Zotero collects the item's information or metadata and saves it to your account. Make sure that you cross-check that the source's important bibliographic information, such as title, author, place and date of publication, have been captured correctly by Zotero. These are listed in Zotero as Doing Your Research Project by Bell. The place of publication is Berkshire. Open University Press is the publisher, and the date is 1999. Quickly cross-reference this information with your source to make sure it matches the information given for the book on library search. Everything is in order here, but if, say, the author's name had been captured incorrectly by Zotero, you could click into the author field to correct it. So next we'll add a journal article to the test folder. Let's go back to library search and look for an example here. We'll search for an article on research design. Using the filters on the left, choose articles and peer-reviewed results and apply filters. Click into the record to view details including the full title of the journal article, the authors, the volume number and issue number, the page ranges and journal publication. Again, click on the Zotero connector and choose the test folder. Going back into Zotero, you can view the title, authors, volume and issue number, page range, publication date, and DOI, as well as the journal it was published in. These are all fields you need to generate your citations and your reference list. It's important to make sure that these essential fields have been captured correctly. Where an item has a URL or DOI listed, just click on the item's title in Zotero to be brought back to the source. This is a great way to easily link back to the article you've read. Okay, let's add one last example. We've captured the information for a book and a journal article, so now we'll add an article from a website. Switch over to the browser, and let's say we want to save this article about research paper sources from the StudyWrite website. Click on the Zotero connector and save the source information to your test folder. Go back into Zotero and have a look at the information that Zotero has captured. You can see here that there's no author listed. That's something that we need to add because it's essential for your citations and your references. So all you need to do is go back to the source, scroll down through the information until you find who the author is. And we can see here that the author is Skyler Anderson. So all you need to do now is go back into Zotero, click on the first box to enter in the author's surname, and then click on the second box to enter in the author's first name. Click anywhere outside the record, and that has now been updated to include the author's full name. So now that we've added three sources to the test folder, we'll use them to generate citations and a reference list in a Word document. In this essay, I refer to ideas I found in the sources that we've looked at. I'll use the source information I've saved into the test folder to cite each source used within the essay and to generate a reference list at the end of the essay. In this first paragraph, I use information found in the web article by Skyler Anderson. To add a citation that points to this source, I go to the Zotero tab in my Word ribbon. This is added to the Word ribbon when you install Zotero. When you click on this, you'll see that boxes appear to the left. Click on Add Edit Citation to add a citation to your essay. The first time that you choose Add Edit Citation, a little box will appear that looks like this. The box will show the different citation styles available to you. Choose the citation style that you're using. Here we'll use Cite Them Right 11th Edition Harvard, but you can choose any of the different styles from the list. If you don't see your particular style on the list, just go to Manage Styles. Choose your citation style and add it to the list. Before you insert your citation, click the cursor to the point at which you'd like the citation to be inserted. Once you've done that, go back to Add Edit Citation, which will open up a Zotero search box that connects to your account. Enter in the author's name or a word from the title of the source, and the Zotero search bar will show sources in your account that contain this word. For this example, we'll type in Anderson. Select the source that you want from the list suggested and press Enter to add the citation to your essay. In the second paragraph, I directly quote from the journal article I saved. According to the rules of Harvard style, when quoting directly from a source, I need to add the page number to the citation. So we'll click on the Zotero tab again, go to Add Edit Citation, and this time we'll type in the word design, and we'll choose the source suggested on the drop-down list. Before clicking on Enter to add the citation into the essay, click on the citation previewed in the Zotero search bar. You'll see here that it's highlighted in blue. A small box will appear. Go down to the page number option and enter the page number you found the direct quotation on. And just hit Enter and Enter again. And now the citation in your essay will include the page number. Finally, we'll add a citation for the book. Click on your Zotero tab, Add Edit Citation, but instead of entering in a keyword from your source, you also have the option to click on the drop-down arrow to go into Classic View, which will bring you into your Zotero folder, where you can select the source that you want. Select Doing Your Research Project, click OK, and Enter to add your citation into your essay. I've now added three in-text citations to my essay, and I want to generate a reference list. At the end of your essay, type in the word references and press Enter. Now all you have to do is click on Add Edit Bibliography, and Zotero generates an A to Z list of references in Harvard style, drawing on the sources that you cited in your essay. Thank you for watching this introduction to Zotero. For more information about Zotero, including how to back up your library and how to share your Zotero folders with other users, see our online Zotero guide on the library website at dcu.ie/library.